Right. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to First Methodist Church on this beautiful Christmas Eve. A couple of quick announcements so that we know what's going to be going on as we end this service this evening. Because as we end Holy Communion, we're going to actually gather outside in the columbarium, and together we're going to sing Silent Night with our candles. We're doing that just for safety and because I want to sing Silent Night. So I hope you all will join us as that's done. So you may either go out the back doors, down the stairs, and over to the columbarium over here, or you can head out through the bell tower. And then you can take the ramp down into that as well. But we will gather. There will be candles that you receive as you enter the columbarium. Also, as you are leaving, following communion, there will be boxes for you to place your communion cups. So when you're finished with that, hang on to those, and there will be a space to dispose of them as you leave. And one last thing, your bulletins that we have for this evening, in order to help be good to the earth and good stewards, we are taking the opportunity to reuse and recycle them. So if you wish to keep it, keep it. But if you're going to throw it out, then there will be baskets for you to set them in so that we can share them at the next services. And so that is it for our announcements. So now let us prepare our hearts this Christmas Eve to receive our King.
Please join now in the reading that is printed in your bulletin. Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. Let us pray. Beloved in Christ, this Christmas Eve, it is our duty and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels and to go in heart and mind to Bethlehem and see the scene which come to pass and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us hear again from Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our sin until the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this house of prayer glad with our carols of praise. But first, because this of all things would rejoice Jesus' heart, let us pray to him for the needs of the whole world and all his people. For peace upon the earth he came to save. For love and unity within the one church he did build. For goodwill among all peoples. And particularly at this time, let us remember the poor, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick, and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in this Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These praises and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven. Amen.
We light this candle to symbolize God's promise fulfilled.
For a child has been born unto us, authority rests on his shoulders.
And his name is Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to all across the earth.
Our first lesson this evening comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, beginning at verse 8. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between you and your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel. By the sweat of your face." And to the man he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return."
Thank you. angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this, and I have not withheld your son, your only son. I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice."
I will be reading Isaiah 9, 2, and 6, and 7. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of darkness, deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulder. And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace from the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish upon it with great justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do it.
Oh,
Our fourth reading comes from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 4a, 6 through 9. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
The birth of Christ inaugurates a new kingdom and a new movement, and this church, First Methodist, is participating in this work. There are three distinct ministries of which tonight's offering will support. The first is this church's partnership with St. Luke United Methodist Church, also here in Asheboro, in promoting racial reconciliation. The second is at Lydia's Place, a vital resource in this community for people, women and children who are unhoused. And the third is the preschool of this church, which for more than 50 years has shaped young people in the love of Christ. Let us now continue our worship through your giving as we give back to the God who has given us everything.
Thank you. The fifth lesson comes from Luke 1, 26 through 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. Virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed.
I've The seventh lesson comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register.
So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
A reading from Luke chapter 2. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in the hands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Thank you. A reading from John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
One of my favorite plays this time of year is the best Christmas pageant ever. I remember my children, when they were very young, acting out in this play and enjoying that, the story of the Herdman family. Some of you may be familiar with this play. the Herdman family who take over the church Christmas play, and they show what the true meaning of Christmas is all about. I believe we have seen the true meaning of Christmas this evening. We have heard the Christmas story. But in the best Christmas pageant ever, they turn the pageant upside down, and in the process, they touch many hearts to find a deeper understanding of the meaning of Christ coming to earth in a manger. The Herdman children do not have involved grown-ups to guide and nurture them, so they develop some unruly and disruptive habits like back-talking, acting out, cigar smoking, shoplifting, and such. They heard, though, that the local church was giving away free snacks if they just came to church. So they showed up one Sunday morning, and they ended up hijacking all the parts of the Christmas pageant. They were not the nicely dressed in new starched Christmas outfits, mind your manners, every hair in place kind of kids. Having never heard the Christmas story, the Herdmans discover something new and are profoundly interested in what they are acting out. Imogene Herdman plays Mary instead of laying the baby doll in the manger by himself during the play. She cradles the baby in her arms and weeps as she holds him. They present the baby Jesus with a ham as a gift to the Christ child. And in the midst of all of this chaos, the youngest Herdman, Gladys, who plays the angel Gabriel, shouts over the crowd in the midst of the noise, "Hey, unto you a child is born. For unto us a child is born." God enters into the world as a baby born in Bethlehem. History and time is now defined by this great event. And God comes to live among God's people, fulfilling the promise of the covenant of Israel. I will walk among you. I will be your God. And you shall be my people. For unto us a child is born. And at his birth, the angel sang, "Peace on earth." There is now the authentic possibility of the peace of heaven being realized on earth as God walks among God's people, for unto us a child is born. The Son of God, born in a manger, a feeding trough, surrounded by livestock and visited by the lowliest of the lowliest of places, rejected by the innkeeper's hospitality, God comes to earth, turning the world into reverse, overturning the expected social norms, choosing to dwell among the least and the lost, choosing to dwell in me and you. For unto us a child is born. And with the indwelling of God among God's people through the babe in the manger, there is hope for the world. With Christ being born, God among us, there is a way of salvation. With the Messiah coming to earth to give us a radical way to love, there is a new means of love. And may the words break through the noise of hatred and injustice and prejudice to bring love and peace to all, this night and forevermore. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. For unto us a child is born. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I now invite you to stand and join me in the invitation, confession, and pardon. The words will be on the screen for your responses. Christ, Christ our Lord invite to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Great and glorious God, through Jesus Christ our Savior, you have shown us that the blessed age of grace has appeared and the hoped-for time of salvation has come. Yet we cling to the glories of the present age. Worldly passions and pursuits, self-centered and unholy ways. We often choose to walk in the darkness, unwilling to see the evil that your light exposes. Cleanse us and free us. Break us from the burden of sin that we carry through Jesus Christ, who was born to give himself for us so that we might be your people in peace and grace. Now let us confess in silence. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. You may be seated. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. And when we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And in the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest and peace to your people on earth." And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. As Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem and there found no room, so Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable Jesus was born, so by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. As your word became flesh, born of woman on that night long ago, so on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet, through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. The bread over which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. The cup over which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. You may take your communion elements, and if you will open the top and remove the wafer and hold the wafer up. If you did not receive communion elements when you came in, you can just raise your hand and the ushers will assist you. Okay. Hold up your wafer. This is the body of Christ given for you. Now you may receive. Now you may open the juice. Hold your cup up. This is the blood of Christ given for you. Now join me in the prayer following communion. Eternal God, on this Christmas Eve, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that your Spirit will cover us and lead us to work for peace on earth. Come, O Emmanuel, come. Amen. Now you are invited to follow us out to the columbarium, and you may go out this way through the bell tower or out the front steps and come around to the gate of the columbarium or come through the ramp at the columbarium. We will meet out there as we will sing Silent Night with Candlelight and dismiss from there.